just landed into Langkawi and it was the shortest flight ever. The flying time was about 15 minutes, I guess. So it was extremely funny. Yeah. So let's see how Langkawi is. And it was the most scenic landing too. I'm gonna add a clip here if possible.
So I've just reached my hotel and this is the property. This is how the reception looks like. And I'm just gonna take you guys inside. Love it here. I'm just gonna take you guys to the place where we are gonna have breakfast in the morning, which is also so pretty. It'll be more lit in the morning, so I will come back and show it to you guys. And we also have a swimming pool right there. So what I really loved about this property is that it has a very heritage feel to it. It has really lush background and the entire space is so beautifully done. Also, the whole space is very inspired by Malaysian culture, and it's very close to Pantai Senang, which is a really popular beach around. Now let me give you guys a room tour of our villa. It has this amazing dining table here, the side table there. There's a really beautiful bed with this canopy and really cool carpets around. It is this beautiful, stunning sitting area with some tea and kettle on the side. And then the best part was the washroom. I really like the aesthetics of it. And it has this really cute wooden tub. I think it's very prominent in the Chinese culture to have these tubs.
Oh my god, the breakfast here looks amazing.
Gonna head to the mangrove tour. We've just booked one yesterday off the road at Pantia Kenang. I think that's the beach here. So let's see. I hope he arrives on time. Hey guys, so I'm at the KM Geo Forest Park. This is where the tour starts from. So in case you haven't pre-booked your tour like I have, you can just drop in here and book the tour from here. It starts around 10 a.m. or if you want to come for the evening one, it starts around 4 p.m. But you might have to wait for the next tour to start. So keep that in mind if you have not pre-booked it. And yeah, also the pricing may be cheaper if you book it from here.
So I think we got a very pretty cheap deal. It was RM90 per person. So we paid like RM180 for me and my mother both. And that comes up to around 2000 INR per person. And now let's begin with the tour. Super excited for this one.
So from the fish farm over here, from the jetty over here, so we're gonna take you to the first place, fish farm. So this is gonna be our first stop. Toilet, fish show, lunch arrangement gonna be there. Right now, for those that have allergies, kind of allergies, vegetarian or so on, tell me over there later so we can modify your lunch. And after that, we're gonna come back to the boat. So we're heading for the eagle watching, mangrove river cruising, crocodile cave, and last but not least gonna be bat cave. Alright, so, and after that we're gonna send you back to your respective area.
So this is the fish farm where we saw incredible varieties of fishes available here. They keep them very nicely and it was so exciting to watch them. Then we headed on to the eagle watching, and the entire ride was so exciting. Now we're on our mangrove tour. We saw these monkeys, threw some food at them and it was so much fun. Then headed deep into the mangroves. By the way, I don't think I caught that, but we also saw a snake here. He was sleeping, because if y'all don't know, snakes usually sleep during the daytime and they're awake at night. The entire experience was so thrilling. So if you're anytime coming to Langkawi, I think this should be on the top of your list. It's really worth it. And now we're entering the crocodile cave. So the cave doesn't really have any crocodiles inside, but the shape of the carving of the cave is in the shape of a crocodile, which is why it's called a crocodile cave. Our guide was just telling us that the crocodile cave is usually filled with water, and it was a good thing that we could ride through it. And now we're here at the bat cave, and we got to see incredible amount of bats. So this, what you can see, is bats sleeping, and they usually again sleep during the day and are awake during the night. So this bat cave is like a circular cave that you can walk around, so we're right in the middle of it, and now we're walking towards the end of the bat cave. Now we're just riding through the islands, and this was honestly the most exciting part of the entire tour. The speed of the boat was so fast. Towards the end of the tour, they usually stop by an island to give you some leisure time, but we couldn't because there was a jellyfish sign, and headed straight for lunch.
So for lunch, we have some chicken crispy with rice and some tom yum soup and some mango chill.
So it's my last evening in Langkawi, and I'm at Hayden Beach. So I'm not gonna lie, Instagram made me come here. I saw this really cool place, Hayden Beach Bar, which is like a sunset beach bar. They have some really cool cocktails, but turns out there's some technical issue and we are all waiting outside to get our tables, and the sun is already setting. So I don't think sunset is happening while we have our drinks, but hoping that we at least get a table and we can grab something to eat after the sunset.
But the good thing is we actually got to witness an incredible sunset by the beach.
And we finally inside!
Now we're just waiting for the fire shows to start, and I've heard so much about it.
We've hit the road again. We're in a cab right now. We're on our way to Genting Highlands. It's our last day here in Malaysia, and we fly back tomorrow morning. So we thought of utilizing the day by going to Genting. Let's see how that goes. There seems to be a little bit of traffic on the way. So let's see. When we reach there, I'll see to show you guys.
Most people here come to just ride the Skyway, because that's the most scenic part about the whole Genting Island experience, and I was super excited about it as usual. So right here where we were, right now we're stepping onto the gondola, but we also have an outlet mall in Genting for all the shopaholics who really want to grab amazing deals on their favorite luxury brands. But yeah, I think the whole point of coming to Genting for us was riding this gondola. Truly is one of the most surreal gondola rides I've been on. You are literally in the middle of the clouds, guys, and it's beautiful.
We're literally inside the clouds.
See, like the Genting clouds.
Oh my god. And that guy is at an amusement park.
So guys, that was it from my Malaysia vlog. I hope you liked it. If you did, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you next time.